bizarre, the unusual. I like it on both Facebook and YouTube.
Romani people. Romanichal. Romanichal travelers, UK/RMNTL/US/NI/. Also Romanichals, Romanichals or Romneys, or English gypsies or English travelers, are a Romani subgroup in the United Kingdom and other parts of the English-speaking world. Romanichal travelers are thought to have arrived in the Kingdom of England in the 16th century. They are very closely related to the Welsh Gael, Scottish Lowland travelers, and groups in Scandinavia. Etymology. The word Romanichal is derived from Romanichal, where chal is Anglo-Romani for fellow. Distribution. Nearly all Romanichal travelers live in England, with smaller communities in South Wales and the Scottish borders. The Romanichal diaspora emigrated from Great Britain to other parts of the English-speaking world. Based on some estimates, there are now more people of Romanichal descent in the United States than in Britain. They are also found in smaller numbers in South Africa, Australia, Canada, and New Zealand, and there is a small Romanichal community in Malta who are descended from British Romanichal migrants who moved there during colonial times. In Great Britain, there is a sharp north-south divide between Romanichal travelers. Southern Romanichal travelers live in the southeast, southwest, Midlands, East Anglia, and South Wales, and Northern Romanichal travelers in the northwest, Yorkshire, and Scottish borders. The two groups' dialects differ in accent and vocabulary. Language. The Romani people in England are thought to have spoken the Romani language until the 19th century, when it was replaced by English and Anglo-Romani, a Creole language that combines the syntax and grammar of English with the Romani lexicon. All Romanichals also speak English. There are two dialects of Anglo-Romani, Southern Anglo-Romani, spoken in the southeast, southwest, Midlands, East Anglia, and South Wales, and Northern Anglo-Romani, spoken in the northeast, northwest, Yorkshire, and Scottish borders. These two dialects, along with the accents that accompany them, have led to two regional Romanichal traveler identities forming, these being the Southern Romanichal identity and the Northern Romanichal traveler identity. Many Anglo-Romani words have been incorporated into English, particularly in the form of British slang. History. The Romani people have origins in India, specifically Rajasthan, and began migrating westwards from the 11th century. The first groups of Romani people arrived in Great Britain by the end of the 16th century, escaping conflicts in southeastern Europe, such as the Ottoman conquest of the Balkans. In 1506, there are recorded Romani persons in Scotland. Arrived from Spain and to England in 1512. Soon the leadership passed laws aimed at stopping the Romani immigration and at the assimilation of those already present. During the reign of Henry VIII, the Egyptians Act, 1530, banned Romanis from entering the country and required those living in the country to leave within 16 days. Failure to do so could result in the confiscation of property, imprisonment, and deportation. During the reign of Mary I, the act was amended with the Egyptians Act, 1554, which removed the threat of punishment to Romanis if they abandoned their naughty, idle, and ungodly life and company and adopted a settled lifestyle, but it increased the penalty for non-compliance to death. In 1562, a new law offered Romanis born in England and Wales the possibility of becoming English subjects if they assimilated into the local population. Despite persecution and this new option, the Romani were forced into a marginal lifestyle and subjected to continuous discrimination from the state authorities and many non-Romanis. In 1596, 106 men and women were condemned to death at York just for being Romani, and 9 were executed. Samuel Ridd authored 2 early works about them in the early 17th century. From the 1780s, gradually, the anti-Romani laws were repealed, although not all. The identity of the Romanichals was formed between the years 1660 and 1800, as a Romani group living in Britain. Persecution. Racism against Romanichal and other traveling peoples is still endemic within Britain. In 2008, the Romani experienced a higher degree of racism than any other group in the UK, including asylum seekers, and a Maori poll indicated that a third of UK residents admitted to being prejudiced against Romani. Shipments to the Americas, Caribbean, and Australia. England began to deport Romanichals, principally to Norway, as early as 1544. The process was continued and encouraged by Elizabeth I and James I. The Finnish Gael, a Romani group in Finland, maintained that their ancestors had originally been a Romani group who traveled from Scotland, supporting the idea that they and the Scandinavian travelers/Romani are distantly related to present-day Scottish Romani and English Romanichals. In 1603, an order in council was made for the transportation of Romanichal to the Low Countries, France, Newfoundland, Spain, and the West Indies. Other European countries forced the further transport of the Romani of Britain to the Americas. Many times those deported in this manner did not survive as an ethnic group because of the separations after the roundup, the sea passage, and the subsequent settlement as slaves, all destroying their social fabric. At the same time, voluntary emigration began to the English overseas possessions. Romani groups that survived continued the expression of the Romani culture there. In the years following the American War of Independence, Australia was the preferred destination for Romanichal transportation due to its use as a penal colony. The exact number of British Romani deported to Australia is unknown. It has been suggested that 3 Romanichal were present on the first fleet, one of whom was thought to be James Squire, who founded Australia's first commercial brewery in 1798, and whose grandson James Farnell, who became the first native-born premier of New South Wales in 1877. The total Romani population seems to be an extremely low number when we consider that British Romani people made up just 0.01% of the original 162,000 convict population. However, it has been suggested that Romanichal was one of the main target groups and was discriminated against due to the transportation laws of England in the mid-18th century. It is often difficult to distinguish British Romani people of Wales and England from the majority of non-Romani convicts at the time, therefore the precise number of British Romanis transported is not known, although there are occurrences of Romani names and possible families within the convict population. However, it is unclear if such people were members of the established Romani community. Fragmentary records do exist, and it is thought with confidence at least 50 or more British Romanis may have been transported to Australia, although the actual figure could be higher. What is clear is that such deportation, as for all convicts, was particularly harsh. For Romani convicts, transportation meant social and psychological death. Exiled, they had little hope of returning to England to re-establish family ties, cultural roots, continuous expression, and validation that would have revived their Romani identity in the convict era. One, however, is known to have returned. Henry Lavello, or Lavelle, was repatriated with a full pardon with a son born to an Aboriginal woman who accompanied him back to England. Slavery. In the 17th century, Oliver Cromwell shipped Romanichals as slaves to the American southern plantations. And there is documentation of English Romanis being owned by freed black slaves in Jamaica, Barbados, Cuba, and Louisiana. Gypsies, according to the legal definition, were anyone identifying themselves to be Egyptians or gypsies. The works of George Borrow reflect the influences this had on the Romani language of England, and others contain references to Romanis being Vicino Fadel or Vice Partel, to be sent across to America or Australia, a period of Romani history not forgotten by Romanis in Britain today. One term reflects this in the contemporary Anglo-Romani for magistrate is Vicaron, Mush, the transporter. Culture. Historically, Romanichals earned a living doing agricultural work and would move to the edges of towns for the winter months. There was casual work available on farms throughout the spring, summer, and autumn months. Spring would start with seed sowing, planting potatoes and fruit trees, early summer with weeding, and there would be a succession of harvests of crops from summer to late autumn. Of particular significance was the hop industry, which employed thousands of Romanichals both in spring for vine training and the harvest in early autumn. Winter months were often spent doing casual labor in towns or selling goods or services door to door. Mass industrialization of agriculture in the 1960s led to the disappearance of many of the casual farm jobs Romanichals had traditionally carried out. During the 20th century onwards, Romanichals became, and remain, the mainstay of asphalt paving, hawking, horse dealing, fortune telling, scrap metal dealing, pre-surgery, tarmac king, traveling funfairs, and wooden rows to make. They have also produced notable boxers such as Henry Warden and Billy Joe Saunders, as well as some notable footballers like Freddie Eastwood, Ben Hughes, Australian and world wit cracking champion, and journalists, psychotherapists, nurses, and all manner of professions. Travel. Originally, Romanichals would travel on foot, or with light, horse-drawn carts, and would build vendor tents where they settled for a time, as is typical of other Romani groups. A vendor is a type of tent constructed from a frame of bent hazel branches. Hazel is chosen for its straightness and flexibility, covered with canvas or tarpaulin. Around the mid to late 19th century, Romanichals started using wagons that incorporated living spaces on the inside. These they called bardos and were often brightly and colorfully decorated on the inside and outside. In the present day, Romanichals are more likely to live in caravans or houses. Over 60% of 21st century Romanichal families live in houses of bricks and mortar, whilst the remaining 40% still live in various forms of traditional traveler modes of transport, such as caravans, trailers, or static caravans. A small minority still live in bardos. According to the Regional Spatial Strategy Caravan Count for 2008, there were 13,386 caravans owned by Romani in the West Midlands region of England, whilst a further 16,000 lived in bricks and mortar. Of the 13,386 caravans, 1,300 were parked on unauthorized sites, that is, on land where Romani were not permitted to park. Over 90% of Britain's traveling Romanichals live on authorized sites where they pay full rates, council tax. On most Romanichal traveler sites, there are usually no toilets or showers inside caravans, because in Romanichal culture this is considered unclean, or mochadi. Most sites have separate utility blocks with toilets, sinks, and electric showers. Many Romanichals will not do their laundry inside, especially not underwear, and subsequently, many utility blocks also have washing machines. In the days of horse-drawn wagons and vardos, Romanichal women would do their laundry in a river, being careful to wash upper body garments further upstream from underwear and lower body garments, and personal bathing would take place much further downstream. In some modern trailers, a double wall separates the living areas from the toilet and shower. Due to the British Caravan Sites Act 1968, which greatly reduced the number of caravans allowed to be pitched on authorized sites, many Romanichals cannot find legal places on sites with the rest of their families. Like most itinerant groups, Romanichals travel around for work, usually following set routes and set stopping places, called achingtans, which have been established for hundreds of years. Many traditional stopping places were established before land ownership changed and any land laws were in place. Many Achin Tams were established by feudal landowners in the Middle Ages, when Romani would provide agricultural or manual labor services in return for lodging and food. Today, most Romani travel within the same areas that were established generations ago. Most people can trace their presence in an area back over 100 or 200 years. Many traditional stopping places were taken over by the local government or by settled individuals decades ago and have subsequently changed hands numerous times. However, Romani have long historical connections to such places and do not always willingly give them up. Most families are identifiable by their traditional wintering base, where they will stop traveling for the winter, and this place will be technically where a family is from. British Acts of Legislation. The Enclosure Act of 1857 created the offense of injury or damage to village green and interruption to its use or enjoyment as a place of exercise and recreation. The Commons Act 1876 makes encroachment or enclosure of a village green and interference with or occupation of the soil unlawful unless it is to improve the enjoyment of the green. The Caravan Sites and Control of Development Act 1960 states that no occupier of the land shall cause or permit the land to be used as a caravan site unless he is the holder of a site license. It also enables a district council to make an order prohibiting the stationing of caravans on common land, or a town or village green. These acts had the overall effect of preventing travelers from using the vast majority of their traditional stopping places, much to the relief of residents. The Caravan Sites Act 1968 required local authorities to provide caravan sites for travelers if there was a demonstrated need. This was resisted by many councils who would claim that no Romanis were living in their areas. The result was that insufficient pitches were provided for travelers, leading to a situation whereby holders of a pitch could no longer travel for fear of losing it. The Criminal Justice and Public Order Act 1994 removed the duty of local councils to provide authorized pitches and gave the council and police powers to move travelers on, subject to certain welfare issues. The official response of the government was that travelers should buy land and apply for planning permission to occupy it. However, those that did so found it extremely difficult to get planning permission, with more than 90% of applications by travelers refused. In the first phase of the Second World War, the Nazis drew up lists of Romani individuals, many of them Romanichals, and persons with Romani ancestry from the United Kingdom to be interned and subjected to pogroms in the event of the country's occupation. The crisis of the 1960s decade, caused by the Caravan Sites Act 1968, stopping new private sites being built until 1972, led to the appearance of the British Gypsy Council to fight for the rights of the Romanichals. In the UK, the issue of travellers, referring to Irish travellers as well as Romanichal and other groups of Romani people, became a 2005 general election issue, with the leader of the Conservative Party promising to review the Human Rights Act 1998. This law, which absorbs the European Convention on Human Rights into UK primary legislation, is seen by some to permit the granting of retrospective planning permission. Severe population pressures and the paucity of greenfield sites have led to travelers purchasing land and setting up residential settlements very quickly, thus subverting the planning restrictions. Romanichal, including other ethnic groups of travelers and Irish travelers, argued in response that thousands of retrospective planning permissions are granted in Britain in cases involving non-Romani applicants each year, and that statistics show that 90% of planning applications by Romanis and travelers were initially refused by local councils, compared with a national average of 20% for other applicants, disproving claims of preferential treatment favoring Romanis. They also argued that the root of the problem was that many traditional stopping places had been barricaded off and that the Criminal Justice and Public Order Act 1994 passed by the previous Conservative government had effectively criminalized their community, for example by removing local authorities' responsibility to provide sites, thus leaving the travelers with no option but to purchase unregistered new sites themselves. Kale, Welsh Romanis. The Kale, also Cala, Valshinange, is a group of Romani people in Wales. Many claims to be descendants of Abram Wood, who was the first Romani to reside permanently and exclusively in Wales in the early 18th century, though Romanichal travelers have appeared in Wales since the 16th century. Welsh kale is almost exclusively found in North Wales, specifically the Welsh-speaking areas. Generally speaking, the kale has employed a tribal structure in which a group of several family units would be under the authority of a male chieftain. However, some kale families are matriarchal, with a senior woman being chosen by consensus among the other women of the family to take the leadership role. The Welsh kale is extremely closely related to Romanichal gypsies/travellers in England, South Wales, and Scottish borders, Lowland Scottish gypsies/travellers, Norwegian and Swedish Romanichal, Tater, gypsies/travellers, and Finnish kale. Language. The kale spoke Welsh Romani. Originally, the variants of Welsh Romani and the Anglo-Romani of the Romanichal constituted a common British Romani language. Both Welsh and English Romani share characteristics and are historically closely related to Romani dialects spoken in France, Germany, Sinti, Scandinavia, Spain, Poland, North Russia, and the Baltic states. Such dialects are descended from the first wave of Romani immigrants into Western, Northern, and Southern Europe in the late Middle Ages. The Welsh Romani language survived in North Wales until at least 1950. In South Wales, a sort of pidgin dialect arose in the late 19th century, mostly consisting of Romani and English, but with other loan words from various languages: Arabic, Iranian, Greek, Romanian, German, French, and Welsh, that indicate the long journey of the kale. Integration into Welsh culture. While preserving their traveling lifestyle, the kale grew to claim several aspects of Welsh culture, including conversion to Christianity, taking on Welsh surnames, and participating in regional and national identity. Notably, John Robert Lewis, the husband of Abram Wood's granddaughter, would win prizes for harping in 1842, 1848, and 1850. Another descendant, John Roberts, earned the sobriquet Telenor Simru, and taught his whole family various instruments. His illustrious career culminated in a performance before Queen Victoria at the Pale Hall on August 24, 1889, on the occasion of the royal visit to Wales. John Roberts played with his 9 sons, all of them, on the harp. Norwegian and Swedish travelers. The Norwegian and Swedish Romanichal travelers, Norwegian, Romanithoket, Tatir, Tegoinera, Swedish, Rizand, Diginair, Tatar, Kandaromani, Romanichal, Romanor, Rom, N, Ani, Tavranger/AR, Tatar, Romani Rakripa, are a group or branch of the Romani people who have been resident in Norway and Sweden for some 500 years. The estimated number of Romanichal travelers in Sweden is 65,000. While in Norway, the number is probably about 10,000. Origins. By history and culture, they are related to British Romani groups, such as English Romanichals, Welsh Kale, and Scottish Lowland Gypsies/travellers. Modern-day Romanichal, Tater, travellers are the descendants of the first Romanis who arrived in Scandinavia during the 16th century. Most were deportees from Britain to Norway, but small numbers came via Denmark. Norwegian and Swedish Romani identify as Romanichal. This word has origins in the Anglo-Romani word Romanichal. Romanichal is the word English Romani and Scottish Border Romani and Southern Welsh Romani used to identify themselves with. A related group is the Finnish Kale, descendants of early Scandinavian Romanis who were deported in the 17th century from Sweden proper to Finland. The Finnish Kale, however, maintain that their ancestors had originally come from Scotland. They and other Scandinavian Romanichal travellers are related to present-day Romanichal travellers of England and Scotland. Romanichal travellers in Norway at times have been confused with the indigenous Norwegian travellers, although they perceive the latter group to be non-Romanese by culture and origins. Names for the group. By the settled majority population, the Norwegian travellers are known as Romanifolk or the exonym Tatir, and in Sweden, they used to be called the similar exonym Tatar, but are named officially under the term Roma today, while the endonyms in use are Dinglera or Rizand. Norwegian travellers most often use the endonyms Rizands or Vandrier. Both exonymous terms hint to the original misconception that these people were Tatars. Before the turn of the 20th century, the majority population made little distinction between Tatir/Tatar and Gypsies, Norwegian, Tegoinera, Swedish, Diginair, This situation changed mainly due to the arrival of Kaldarash Roma from Russia and Central Europe in the last decades of the 19th century, to whom the latter term came to be applied almost exclusively. Hojer was a former name for travelers in Sweden. In Norway, Spoyer was associated with indigenous travelers. Fant or Fanter was another term formerly applied to both Romani and non-Romani travelers in southern Norway. A lot of these terms nowadays are considered pejorative due to their connotation of vagabondage and vagrancy. In Sweden, tatter is now considered a disparaging term and has been completely abandoned in official use. Since 2000, Swedish travelers are officially referred to as resand, travelers, and counted as one of several groups within the Roma national minority. They often refer to themselves as resandifolket, traveling people, or dingler. Less common is the term tavringer. In recent years, there has been an attempt to term Swedish travelers as skiwi, but this usage is contested. For Norwegian travelers, however, the name tatir is severely disputed. For one part, it does not carry the same stigma as in Sweden. The counterpart has for many years fought for the same rights as Swedish Romani. Some traveler organizations maintain this term in their official names. In Norway, the travelers are categorized as a national minority group, officially referred to as Romanifolk or Tatier, rise end, travelers. Norwegian travelers refer to themselves by various names, such as Romani, Romanor, Romanisal, Vandrier, Wanderers, etc. In contrast to Sweden, in Norway, a distinction is made between Romanifolket and Rom, i.e., Roma groups that arrived since the 19th century in the official legislation on national minorities. Language. The travelers in Sweden and Norway speak a form of the Romani language referred to as Skandaromani. Many words of the Nordic Romani origin have survived in the Scandinavian languages, both in common speech and slang. Examples: Jej, meaning girl in Swedish, originally slang, but now a popular alternative to the older flicka. Pupra, meaning gun in Swedish, used to be common slang. Hack, meaning place, as in joint or establishment, in Swedish, common slang. Vischan, meaning the countryside, as in boondocks or rural areas, in Swedish, common slang. Organizations. Romani travelers in Sweden and Norway have founded organizations for preserving their culture and lobbying for their collective rights. One example is Forningen Resandifolkets Riksorganisation, based in Malmö, Sweden. Media. Romani Posten, also Romaniposten, the Romani Post, ISSN 0809-8379, was a news magazine for the Romani traveler community in Norway. It had no political or religious affiliation and published articles in Norwegian. At its most frequent, it came out 8 times per year. On September 6, 2003, it was founded as an online publication. The first print edition was published in October 2006. Joan Pedersen was the founding publisher and editor-in-chief. As of 2007, it had ceased publication. Scottish Gypsy and Traveller Groups. Scottish travellers, or the people in Scotland loosely termed gypsies or travellers, consist of many diverse, unrelated communities that speak a variety of different languages and dialects that pertain to distinct customs, histories, and traditions. 4 distinct communities identify themselves as gypsies / travellers in Scotland: Indigenous Highland travellers, Romani Lowland travellers, Scottish Border Romanichal traveller, Border Gypsies, and Showmen, Funfair travellers. Lowland travellers and Border Romanichal travellers, Romani groups. Lowland Scottish Gypsies / travellers. The ethnic origins of Scottish Lowland travellers are not clear, but can be categorized into 2 main theories. 1. They are Romani in origin and have a common ancestry with the English Romanichal. And their language and culture simply diverged from the language and culture of the Romanichal, like what happened with the Welsh Gael. 2. They are fusion or a mix of Romani and an indigenous lowland Scottish traveler group, and their roots are just as Romani as they are Scottish. Regardless of both theories, Lowland Gypsies are still viewed as a Romani group, with Romani culture being a massive part of Scottish Lowland Gypsy culture. Lowland Scottish Romani Gypsy / travelers share many cultural features with other Romani Gypsy communities, such as a belief in the importance of family and family descent, a strong valuing and involvement with extended family and family events, a preference for self-employment, purity taboos. Among the Romani people, the purity taboos are part of the Romanichal, and a strong commitment to an itinerant lifestyle. They are particularly very closely related to the Romani groups of England, Wales, Norway, Sweden, and Finland. History. There is written evidence for the presence of Roma travelers in the Scottish lowlands as early as 1505, when, during the reign of James IV, an entry in a book kept by the Lord High Treasurer records a payment of 4 shillings to a Peter Kerr to take a letter from the king at Hunt Hall to the king of Romes. 2 days later, the king authorized a payment of £20 to a messenger from the king of Romes. In 1530, a group of Romanis danced before the Scottish king at the Holy Writ Palace, and a Romani herbalist called Baptista cured the king of an ailment. Romani migration to Scotland continued during the 16th century, and several groups of Romanis were accepted there after being expelled from England. Records in Dundee from 1651 note the migrations of small groups of people called Egyptians in the Highlands, and are noted to be of the same nature as the English Gypsies. By 1612, communities of Romanis were recorded to exist as far north as Skalaway in the Shetland Islands. The Finnish Gael, a Romani group in Finland, maintain that their ancestors were originally a Romani group who traveled to Finland from Scotland, which supports the idea that they and the Scandinavian Romani travelers are distantly related to present-day Scottish Lowland Romani Gypsies. Romani people in the south of Scotland enjoyed the protection of the Roslin family and made an encampment within the Roslin castle grounds. However, as with its neighbor England, the Scottish Parliament passed an act in 1609 against Romani groups known as the Act Against the Egyptians, which made it lawful to condemn, detain, and execute gypsies if they were known or reputed to be ethnically Romani. Scotland has had a Romani population for at least 500 years. They are a distinct group from the Highland Traveller and share a common language and heritage with the English Gypsies and Welsh Gael. They enjoyed a privileged place in Scottish society until the Reformation, when their wandering lifestyle and exotic culture brought severe persecution upon them. Romani populations from other parts of Britain often travel in Scotland. These include English Romanis and Welsh Gael. English Romanichal Gypsies / travelers from the north of England, mainly in Newcastle upon Tyne and Cumbria, as well as an annual gathering at Appleby Horse Fair, may be part of common communities with Scottish travelers living in the lowlands and borders. Romanichal traders were upwardly mobile. By 1830, traveled to the potteries in Staffordshire and buying china and other goods, selling the items chiefly in Northumberland, while based in Kirkyandholm in Roxburghshire. By 1874, these gypsies were commented on as having physical markers in their dusky complexion that is characteristically gypsy, and a Romani language. Some people from the Scottish traveling community are even members of Romani organizations based in England and are a minority group in Scotland. Includes Romanis of English heritage in Scotland. The Lowland Gypsies had a royal family from an early date. The FAA family occupied this role until 1847, when it passed to the Blythes, commonly called FAA Blythes. The last king died in 1902, and there have been no more recent claimants. Besides the Fawes and Blythes, common border gypsy surnames include Bailey, Tate, Douglas, Gordon, MacDonald, Ruthven, Young and Flecky. Scottish border Romanichal travelers, Scottish border gypsies. It is also important to note that Romanichal traveler communities exist in the Scottish borders. They are linguistically, due to speaking Anglo-Romani, and culturally, due to following Romanichal traditions and customs, identical to the Romanichal traveler communities in England and South Wales, as well as the Romanichal diaspora communities around the world. They are known locally as border gypsies / travelers. They live in separate and distinct communities from Scottish Lowland travelers, although both are Romani. Scottish Cant or Scottish Romani. The Lowland Gypsies speak a form of non-standard Scots language, called Cant, which includes many words in common with Romani, including Anglo-Romani words. Between 25 to 35% of Scottish Cant originates in a Romani-derived lexicon, containing up to 50% or more Romani loan words in some groups of the central belt of Scotland. Music and song. The Raggle Taggle, Gypsies, 1720. Donnie Monroe's Were the Roses and Queen of the Hill, from the album Interus, is based on the author's childhood experiences with the Tinker people in the Scottish Highlands. Television. Morrow the Gypsy, 1972, television dramatization by the Children's Film and Television Foundation Ltd. A story about a family of gypsies and the discrimination and hostility they experience in a Scottish village when they apply for a permanent campsite. When chickens start to disappear and scrap metal litters the countryside, the time has come for Morrow and his family to be moved on, but the gypsy family are innocent and were framed by the locals and are allowed to stay. The film received a special award for contribution to racial tolerance by the Moscow International Film Festival in 1973. Novels and short stories. Scottish Traveller Tales, Lives Shaped Through Stories by Donald Braid, 2002, The Storytelling and Ballad Traditions of the Nomadic Minority of Scottish Travellers. Pilgrims in the Mist, Stories of Scotland's Travelling People by Sheila Stewart, a collection of traveller stories from across Scotland. Northern Traveller Tales by Robert Dawson, traditional tales collected from travellers in the East Midlands, north of England and Scotland. Travellers, an introduction by John Cannon and the Travellers of Thistlebrook, insight into the history, culture, and lives of travellers in Britain today. Rockering, Crecking, and Cracking by Robert Dawson, the Romani language and Cant dialects of travellers and gypsies found in present day today. Non-Romani groups. Indigenous Highland Travellers. In Scottish Gaelic, they are known as the Siardannan, the craftsmen. Or less controversially, Lucht Siadhael, people of travel, or travellers in general. Poetically known as the Summer Walkers, Highland Travellers are a distinct ethnic group and may be referred to as Travellers, Travellan Thauk, in Scots, Thinkers, originating from the Gaelic Tinsard or Tinsmith, or Black Tinkers. Mistakenly, the settled Scottish population may call all travelling in Romani groups tinkers, which is usually regarded as pejorative, and contemptuously as tinks or twinkies. Highland travellers are closely tied to the native Highlands, and many traveller families carry clan names like MacPhee 19 Stewart, MacDonald, Cameron, Williamson, and Macmillan. They follow a nomadic or settled lifestyle, passing from village to village, and are more strongly identified with the native Gaelic-speaking population. Continuing their nomadic life, they would pitch their bout tents on the rough ground on the edge of the village and earn money there as tinsmiths, hawkers, horse dealers, or pearl fishermen. Many found seasonal employment on farms, e.g. at the berry picking or during harvest. Since the 1950s, however, the majority of Highland travellers have settled down into organized campsites or regular houses. Adam Smith, the economist and philosopher, was reportedly kidnapped by Highland travellers at a young age before quickly being freed. Language. The Highland traveller's speech includes a dialect called Berlerigaird. It is related to the Irish traveller Shelta as a creole of the Goidelic language group. It was used as a cultural identifier, just as Romani groups used the Romani language. However, like the Highland travelers themselves, the language is only distantly related to the Romani languages. Origins and customs. The Highland traveler community has a long history in Scotland going back, at least in a record, to the 12th century as a form of employment, and one of the first records of that name states that James the Tinker held land in the town of Perth from 1165 to 1214 and share a similar heritage, although they are distinct from the Irish travellers. As with their Irish counterparts, there are several theories regarding the origin of Scottish Highland travellers, one being they are descended from the Picts. Excommunicated clergy. To families fleeing the Highland potato famine, or the pre-Norman invasion, have been claimed at different times. Highland travellers are distinct both culturally and linguistically from other gypsy groups like the Romani, including the Romanichal, Lowland Scottish Gypsies, Eastern European Roma, and Welsh Cael groups. Several other European groups are non-Romani groups, namely the Yeniks, Woonwagen bewoners in the Netherlands, indigenous Norwegian travelers and Landfahrer in Germany. As with indigenous Norwegian travelers, Highland travelers' origins may be more complex and difficult to ascertain and left no written records of their own. As an indigenous group, Highland travelers have played an essential role in the preservation of traditional Gaelic culture. Travelers' outstanding contribution to Highland life has been as custodians of an ancient and vital singing, storytelling, and folklore tradition of great importance. It is estimated that as little as 2,000 Scottish travelers continue to lead their traditional lifestyle on the roads. Notable Highland travelers. Lizzie Higgins, a Scottish folk singer, daughter of Jeannie Robertson. Jeannie Robertson, a Scottish folk singer. Belle Stewart, a Scottish traditional singer. Sheila Stewart, daughter of Belle Stewart, who was awarded the British Empire Medal for services to her country's cultural oral tradition in Scots and Gaelic. Duncan Williamson, author/storyteller, who wrote down the oral history, stories, and ancient tales of the Highland Traveller. He recorded over 3,000 stories over his lifetime. Stanley Robertson, master storyteller, ballad singer, and author of several books of Lowland Traveller tales. Nephew of Jeannie Robertson. In popular culture, Rob Roy, 1995 film featuring Liam Neeson that details the exploits of the early 18th century Scottish clan chief and outlaw Rob Roy MacGregor. The film opens with MacGregor and his clansmen retrieving 32 stolen head of cattle from a band of travelers led by Tam Sibbalt. After killing Sibbalt, MacGregor disarms the others, whom he calls thinkers, and allows them to go. After his return home, Mary MacGregor, Jessica Lange, expresses shock when her husband expresses sympathy for the travelers, saying that they once had families and clans to which they belonged. She is even more shocked when he compares the travelers' poverty with that of their clan. She insists the MacGregors were never tinkers. In response, Rob tells her that many MacGregors are only one bad winter away from joining the travelers. He explains that his greatest fear is of finding some of his clansmen among them. Death-Defying Act, a film about Harry Houdini and his encounter with a Scottish traveler woman and her daughter. Memoirs, fiction, etc. Scottish Traveler Tales, Lives Shaped Through Stories, by Donald Braid, 2002, The Storytelling and Ballad Traditions of the Nomadic Minority of Scottish Travelers. The Yellow on the Broom, The Early Days of a Traveler Woman, Betsy White, 1919-88, 1992, Life on the Road for Scottish Travelers in the Early Part of the 20th Century. The Yellow on the Broom is a song which Adam McNaughton wrote for Betsy White to sing 25. Red Rowans and Wild Honey, by Betsy White, 2004, the sequel to Yellow on the Broom, The Life of Scottish Travelers, till the outbreak of the Second World War. Red Eye Ghost by Mickey McPhee, the story of a Scottish traveler who encounters a ghostly victim of the Highland clearances. Last of the Tinkers, by Sheila Douglas, 2006, a collection of stories, songs, and anecdotes from Willie McPhee, providing a link between the ancient history of his people and their situation in present-day Scotland. Northern Traveller Tales by Robert Dawson, traditional tales collected from travellers in the East Midlands, north of England and Scotland. The Summer Walkers, travelling people and pearl fishers in the Highlands of Scotland, Timothy Nest 2008, the story of the itinerant tinsmiths, horse dealers, hawkers, and pearl fishers who made their living on the road in the Highlands of Scotland. Jessie's Journey, by Jess Smith, 2003, the first book of a trilogy and an autobiographical account of stories from the Highland Traveller family. Here's for a Tinker by Jess Smith, 2005, the third book of a trilogy, recounting a collection of stories from the author's family tales, ghosts, poems, tales of the road from a family of Scottish Highland travelers. Tales from the Tent, by Jess Smith, 2008, the third book of a trilogy of stories from the author's own folk tales. Rower's Rest, by Jess Smith, 2006, a story of love and loyalty and the journey a woman makes for the love of her husband. Stuck in Berries, by Jess Smith, 2006, a collection of stories for younger readers, ancient oral tales of Scotland's travelling people. Queen Among the Heather, The Life of Belle Stewart, by Sheila Stewart, 2006. The moving autobiography and life of Belle Stewart, traveler, folk composers, and singer who was awarded the British Empire Medal for her contribution to folk music. Pilgrims in the Mist, Stories of Scotland's Traveling People, by Sheila Stewart, a collection of traveler stories from across Scotland. Never to Return, The Harrowing True Story of a Stolen Childhood, by Sandy Reid, 2008, the true story of a family of tinker children taken from their families. The Book of Sandy Stewart, by Alexander Stewart, 1988, biography of a Perthshire tinker. The Last of the Tinsmiths, The Life of Willie McPhee, by Sheila Douglas, 2006, a collection of songs, tales, and stories from the rich Highland traveling people. The Horseyman, Memories of a Traveler, 1928-58, by Duncan Williamson, Memoirs of a Traveler Family Living at Loch Fyne. The King and the Lamp, Scottish Traveler Tales, by Duncan Williamson, 2000, a collection of stories from the rich oral tradition of the Scottish Highland Travelers. Fireside Tales of the Traveler Children, by Duncan Williamson, 2009, a collection of traditional traveling stories. No Easy Road, by Patsy White, 2009, memoir of a traveler child separated from family and taken into care in the 1950s. Horse Healer, Eclipse, and Other Stories in the Horse Healer series, by Judy Waite, 2007, includes some short stories based on Highland travelers. McCold, Ewan, Seeger, Peggy, 1986. Till Doomsday in the Afternoon, The Folklore of a Family of Scots Travelers, The Stewarts of Blairgowrie. Manchester, University Press. ISBN 0-7190-1813-7. Fairground Travelers. Traveling Funfair Showmen are a community of travelers officially called occupational travelers, which can be categorized broadly defined as a business community of traveling show, circus communities, and fairground families. Occupational travelers travel for work across Scotland, the rest of the UK, and into Europe. The show/fairground community is close-knit, with ties often existing between the older Romanichal families, although showman families are a distinct group and have a vibrant social scene centered both around the summer fairs and the various sites and yards used as winter quarters. Many Scottish show and fairground families live in winter communities based mainly on the east end of Glasgow. Housing an estimated 80% of all show families, Glasgow is believed to have the largest concentration of showman quarters in Europe, centered mostly in Shettleston, White Inch, and Carntyne. Showman families have a strong but relatively recent cultural identity as Scottish showmen, dating back to 1889 and the formation of the Showman's Guild of Great Britain and Ireland, and are known within the UK as the Scottish Section. As with other showman communities, they call non-travelers, including members of the public, and other non-related traveling groups, including Romanichal, Roma, Scottish Lowland Traveller / Gypsy Groups, and Highland Traveller, Irish Travellers, as Flatties or non-dash showmen in their own Polari language. The label of Flatty Traveller can include showmen who have left the community to settle down and lead a sedentary lifestyle. History. Fairs in Scotland have been held from the early Middle Ages, and traditionally brought together the important elements of medieval trade and a festival. Many of the common markets and fairs are rooted in ancient times, from the medieval period or earlier, and are said to be prescriptive fairs. Other fairs will have been granted a royal charter to cement their importance and secure their future, and these are known as charter fairs. In the Middle Ages, the royal charters gave the fairs legal status and developed their economic importance. The majority of fairs held in Scotland and the rest of the British Isles can trace their ancestry to charters granted in the medieval period. Traders would travel long distances to sell their goods, as did traveling musicians and entertainers who kept both the traders and customers entertained. In the 13th century, the creation of fairs by royal charter was widespread. Between 1199 and 1350, charters were issued granting the rights to hold markets or fairs. Kirkcaldy Links Market remains the premier fun fair in Scotland, evolving from a charter granted by Edward I in 1304. By the early 18th century, the main aspect of these Scottish charter fairs had diminished and shifted to that of amusement with the advent of technology and had evolved into the modern-day traveling fairs. The modern traveling showmen have a strong family history and heritage, as do their counterparts in Wales, England, and Ireland. Fairs in Scotland are presented around the same time as they are in the rest of Great Britain and Ireland, with a similar mixture of charter, prescriptive and private business fairs. The run of fairs includes Bucky Fair, Inverness, Kirkcaldy Links Market, and the historic fairs held at Dundee and Arbroath. Annually, a team of young showmen from both Scotland and England plays an international football match known as the International, where trophies and caps are held in high esteem. A showman newspaper, World's Fair, is in circulation and available to showmen and non-showmen alike. Language. The use of slang used by showmen or parliery is based on a cant slang spoken throughout the UK by Scottish, English, Welsh, and Irish show families. It is a mixture of Mediterranean, lingua franca, Romani, Yiddish, cant London slang, and back slang. The language has been spoken in fairgrounds and theatrical entertainment since at least the 17th century. As theatrical booths, circus acts, and menageries were once a common part of European fairs, it is likely that the roots of polari/parliery lie in the period before both theater and circus became independent of the fairgrounds. The parliery spoken on fairgrounds tends to borrow much more from Romani, as well as other languages and argos spoke by other traveling groups, such as cant and back slang.
This is brought to you by the strange, the bizarre, the unusual. I like it. Thanks for watching. If you like the video, please like, subscribe, share, make comments. We love feedback.